Hi, thanks for tuning in to Turn to the Stars. My name is Andrea Clem, and I am an astrological counselor and a shamanic practitioner from the local area. And today's show, as you can see on the bottom of the screen, is entitled Astrology News, August through September of 2013. And I thought it would be kind of fun today because we are on a full moon tonight at exactly 9:13 p.m. We are having the second full moon in the zodiac sign of Aquarius at exactly 28 degrees and 10 minutes. And that energy is so expansive right now. Emotions are big, and you know, emotion drives our sensitivity and drives us to take action on things. So it does bring to us all a full awareness collectively. That means on so many levels, spirit, soul, mind, and body, that we have reached a turning point historically with the structural changes that have been manifesting in our lives. This energy of this full moon shows us that we've achieved goals, and we each realize so much more about the major breakthroughs that we've experienced, especially people who've been stuck in old patterns. And you've heard me talk about that in the past on the shows, that that is primarily a very incredibly big thing in most people's lives right now. And so people who have planets placed in the signs of Leo, Aquarius, Taurus, or Scorpio have been most influenced to take a look at these patterns. And it could be, you know, it might not be that you are an Aquarius or a Leo or a Taurus or a Scorpio, but you have planets in your birth chart in these astrological signs. And that you would know by, you know, getting a copy of your birth chart. So these are people that would be the most influenced. And this is a month where we finally find we're able to accept what we couldn't control. This month has truly provided the gifts in realization and of the effects to everyone. So, as I said before, this is the second full moon we've had in the sign of Aquarius in 30 days. And this second full moon in Aquarius does stir up a need to be inventive and to connect with friends or community that you're active with to make plans or resolve unfinished affairs. So this full moon does, it can help us to release and move away from old belief patterns we've been a part of up till now. And as you've heard me say before, full moons do bring that full awareness. And so all these things I've just mentioned are very, very big, lit up, in full awareness at this time. So that's tonight. If you look in the sky tonight, you'll see, and today is August 20th, 2013, Tuesday. If you look in the sky tonight, you will see that full, beautiful, lighted full moon. And the Sabian symbol, you've heard me talk about Sabian symbols in other shows. Sabian symbols are a way to provide a further insight. They take a look at the particular degrees of a zodiac sign, and the one for tonight at 28 degrees brings to the mind a picture of an old tree that has been cut down and is sawed up. So see that picture in your mind, an old tree cut down and sawed up. And so this to me means old patterns have fallen away and they've been analyzed and cut up for redistribution. We now use what is old and worn out in a different way, and things now look very different, creating new ideas for approaching the future. And the next major astrological event is on August 25th, and that's only 5 days away from today. And that's why you see on the bottom of the screen, I'm talking about August through September and touching on some important points. So August 25th, as we see on that date, a second Star of David. And, you know, before I move to that, I think I did miss showing you the chart of the full moon on the screen. And there it is. And we can see that full moon is when the sun and the moon are exactly opposite in our universe. And that's what an astrology map is a picture of what the universe looks like, what our solar system looks like. And you can see around the bottom of the chart, right about 4 or 5 o'clock is a glyph, which is a symbol of the sun, a circle with a dot, 28 degrees Leo, and the top left corner is the moon at 28 Aquarius. And I was describing those influences in the the information I talked about prior to this. So and this next astrological event, which is on August 25th, this one here is actually a second star of David that's going to be lighting up our solar system on August 25th. And this one is a twin to the one that took place on July 29th. I did a whole show on that star of David and the Merkaba and the tetrahedron and what that all meant. And I talked about this August 25th Star of David that would be appearing, and because this one is actually a twin Star of David, and it is the first time that we've had this twin Star of David, meaning two of them appear within a 30-day period. And I'm going to show that on the screen right now with that chart. Look, this is the July 29th one, and that one is, you can see, these are what we call two triangles or grand trines and different elements, one of them being earth and the other one being water. And the next chart is this one, the August 25th, and that's the one that's coming up very soon. And this Star of David closes the portal that remained open for almost a month, that provided an opening for the heavens to touch the earth and the earth to connect with the heavens. And this second star of David, which you're seeing on the screen right now, this is the actual symbol of what will actually be happening between the planets, and it actually forms this star. There is a little difference where on the July 29th Star of David, we saw up in the right-hand corner, you see Venus there at 8 degrees of Virgo. Now, if you jump to the August 25th, we see Mercury in that same spot where Venus was on July 29th. Now, this one, so what does this mean? We look to see Mercury in Virgo in the star on the 25th, indicating that communication will be key to the resolve of any power struggles that occurred during this month. Deep thought and investigation into the root of a thought will provide answers and resolve. So these stars of David, this one actually closes the portal. They provided an opening. That's what a portal is, an opening, a passageway for energy to manifest, for heaven to manifest on earth and earth to connect with the heavens. Incredibly beautiful energy. And what it provided was, and held, was a memory. A memory was restored to all of us during this time of how love, deep thought, and communication bring resolve. So that is the last one, and we're going to see that one formed by the stars on August 25th. The next astrological event is the new moon that we're going to be seeing on September 5th. And this is very significant. You know, I always on the show talk about the new moon to the full moon, and because they are cute, you know, they are very important indicators of a new theme or building of experience in our lives. So this new moon will occur on September 5th, 2013 at 5:50 a.m. here on the East Coast, and it will be at exactly 13 degrees of Virgo. So I do want to say happy birthday to all the Virgos. I know we have a couple Virgos at this TV station here, and I have a husband who's a Virgo, so happy birthday to all the Virgos. And I'll show you a new moon chart on the screen. And this is, you see the blue arrow pointing down, that shows the sun and the moon together. And it shows us this new moon at 13 degrees of Virgo. And this Mercury, Virgo actually is the ruler of Virgo, and it reminds us that there is a significant theme for this month to stay in our routines, practicing and working on what we want to develop, and to pay extra attention to detail. Our health and healthcare methods will be under the microscope. This is a great month to begin a new healthcare regimen and or to perfect one. And the Sabian symbol, as you heard me talk about on the full moon, that provides further insight for this degrees of this new moon is actually to, you know, in your mind's eye, see a picture of a man who is a powerful figure in our society. And, you know, such as maybe a senator or a congressman or a mayor, and see him overcoming a state of hysteria. And that's the picture. Hold that picture for a minute, because this picture reminds us that those things we may have experienced that cause hysteria or anxiety within the last past months, things that we've worried about, things that have caused us to be uneasy and finding it hard to focus, that those things are going to become front and center, and that we're, with this concentration of this new moon in Virgo, it does help us to focus and stay more grounded. So that all of that's required is to keep your feet on the ground, stay focused, and present, and even if you feel like quitting or running away, just keep on walking slowly and surely. You'll overcome in any anxiety of that old story. Virgo is one of those mutable signs. It's one that says there'll be a little work, but if you can break things down, analyze them, reorganize them, those will be the things that will be most important as we step into this new moon energy. And we can already, you know, once we get past this full moon on August 20th and the days begin to progress further, we can actually, a week or more before that new moon comes in, everything is quickening these days and it seems to come in a lot faster. So I have a little video that I created to sort of reach out to everybody, to remind you that emotion is a major driver toward all of us in achieving our goals. So I'm going to play that video, and it sort of sums up what we're talking about today. So I hope you enjoy that.
When I wake up in the morning light, blue jeans on, I pull my old blue jeans on. I pull my blue jeans on, I pull my old blue jeans on. It's the weekend and I know that you're free, so pull on your jeans and come on out with me. I need to have you near me, I need to feel you close to me.
So I had that song playing through my head this morning, and I said, you know what, I gotta make a video of with that music and enjoy a little bit of entertainment during the show today. So you know, Virgo is interesting because it does require that we pay attention to detail, and it also finds us, you know, going after the things that we really enjoy doing on a day-to-day basis, and looking for ways that we can help other people to perfect their lives. Virgo is the one that can see the little things that others don't see. It can point out that detail. They can put their finger on that little thing that was missed. So they're great to have a part of your team. So also on that new moon in Virgo, we also see that Saturn is still in Scorpio, and so it holds that promise that asks for, that whatever we're interested in, whatever we're working on, whatever we're concentrating on, that it does still ask us that for a total investment in what we're doing, because we are restructuring, we're identifying things that haven't worked before, and we're sort of wiggling out of that old skin and into a new place. And we see Uranus and Pluto are still in the first quarter square, which you've seen me talk about in other shows. There's seven squares that Uranus and Pluto are going to form till the year of 2015. And so it's necessary, it holds that promise that it's necessary to continue to restructure our lives in the line with the energy of growth. Concentration on our power and our power centers and that sort of regeneration. Uranus and Pluto will be in that first quarter for two more years until 2015, giving plenty of time for us to make this new system solid. On that new moon, we see Saturn, Jupiter, and Neptune are still in a grand water trine. So the flow of emotion currently is still influencing us and will carry us through whatever we put our energy into. Mars in this new moon chart is the energy we need and is in Leo. It provides the energy we need, and because it's in Leo on that new moon chart and it is trining Uranus in Aries, this is a fire trine, which gives us the passion. It sort of stirs up the passion and brings in the inspiration and the energy to apply toward whatever it is that we're doing. Mars in Leo wants us to take action in finding ways to express things that we want to be recognized and noticed for. And Leo is just like that. And so when you see a fire grand trine occurring on a new moon, it promises that we'll have the ability to take the action to change things, that we'll be taking actions to create things, that we'll be taking action to become more aware, and even we'll be able to be sort of inventive and take action on things that require us to be courageous and more, less fearful. Also on this new moon, we have a Earth trine with the new moon in Virgo and Pluto in Capricorn. This energy influence opens a door for a positive, methodical, and practical reorganization. It promises a grounded and stable flow of power, which is easily concentrated. So this new moon in Virgo month is a reminder for us to review the path that we have traveled since this past May. Then to integrate, make final adjustments, finish up, perfect those areas that we've become aware of that have changed, and to be of service to those we can. So I have two slides or pictures I want to show you, and these are of the psychic fair that we have coming up on September 7th, Saturday, September 7th. This is going to be our 20th bi-monthly holistic fair. This is such a great event, and the theme of this fair is the magic of your beliefs, and it is from 10 o'clock to 4 o'clock, and we are at Turn to the Stars. My family does facilitate this at the Yard Seafood and Steakhouse in Salon B. They are the nicest people there. They are so accommodating, and everybody seems to be really becoming aware of this great event. As you can see, we've been doing this for the last 3 years, and we have a great group of readers, and I'll show you that on the screen right now. Readers, healers, vendors, and I'll leave that up just for a minute. We have astrology readings that I'll be doing, psychic mediumship, angel chakra readings with Ann Mitz, mediumship, animal communication with Danielle Dion, psychic mediumship, spiritual special angel readings, and that is by Eric Goldberg. And he's a very, very nice man, very gifted. Mediumship and angel guidance readings with Irene Chu. And Jean Lujan Gray doing psychic mediumship. And that takes a shamanic approach. And then psychic medium, Akashic record readings with Jessica Frost. Jessica has been with us for a couple years now. She's just an incredibly gifted lady. Judy Seidel doing intuitive goddess oracle readings. She has some spectacular, beautiful cards she's created that she uses in her readings, which are incredible. Really, she does a great reading. Lori Otto, intuitive readings. And Lori is very good with connecting with you and providing that connection of intuition to help you on your life path. And then we have palmistry, tarot, orogram readings with Shannon Shedd. Wendy Fletcher is doing healing therapy, hands-on healing, and spirit channeling. And Wendy Van De Paul, very gifted lady, doing muscle whispering, soul level animal communication, psychic and intuitive readings. She really does a great psychic reading, and she's in tune with your health and well-being, so she's really helpful. And vendors, we have Omega Point Healing Crystals and Gems with Linda Goodwin, Inspiration Boxes, Motivation to Go. These are by Carrie Hagen. They're really beautifully done. And there's a message for every single day, inspirational. And Jeff Travers. Jeff is doing the Northwood Naturals and Ellen Soy candles. His candles are just absolutely awesome. I have one in every room in my house, and the house always smells so nice. And Roberta Horseman. Roberta's Herbs and Gems. And then we have Ashley and Donna are new to the fair, but they are coming in vending intuitive crafts, dream catchers, and medicine bags. And I can't wait to see, because they sound really great. So I hope you'll stop by and see us, and just join us for this magic of our of your beliefs event. And so continuing on with energy of that new moon in Virgo, it does inspire people though to be sort of picky about little things, and that can sort of sting a bit if you're really sensitive. But what I do love about the Virgo energy is that it's supportive of identifying the little things, the details, the matters that are easily missed by the normal processes of everyday life. So your job this month is to break down matters at hand, analyze them, put them under the microscope. And then as time progresses and we grow closer to the full moon on September 19th, reorganize whatever you have identified and discerned or felt requires attention. And I have an interesting picture here of, I call it a Virgo picture, and it just gives you some information. You know, the picture is interesting because it looks at time. The sign of Virgo is the analyst, the priestess, you know, the perfectionist, the oracle person. Time is important, organization is important, but they're very good at discerning time and energy. This month, remember, there's a place for everything and everything has its place. Organize and schedule your daily routine. Growth through challenges, perfectionism, and overanalyzing sometimes can be a very good thing. So, as Virgo is a earth sign, this will require some work and attention. It will ask you to be present to go through this process. At this time, you know, sometimes it may seem a little harsh. Virgo, as I said before, is not a sensitive sign, and it asks for a slow and methodical working concentration to get the job done. So as we proceed toward September 19th, which is the full moon in Pisces, it will bring to our awareness a feeling and an understanding and reminder that healthy boundaries are very important. It's like putting on a new pair of jeans. There's just this good feeling that you've achieved that perfection that you've been striving for. And so this energy this month with this new moon in Virgo, what you'll see growing is a reminder that gives all of us ways to help others who are suffering. It'll remind us that compassion and gentleness are important, but also important is to discern what is healthy. The full moon on September 19th will bring us to our awareness any behaviors which have been obsessive or areas which we are extremely sensitive about. So this month will be especially important for you if you are a Virgo, Pisces, Gemini, or Sagittarius, or have planets in these zodiac signs in your birth chart, which are between the degrees of 10 and 16. So if you were to look in your birth chart and you saw any planets that were between the degrees of 10 and 16, you would feel, you would have experiences, you would have these things I talked about manifesting in your life. So I hope it's a great month for you, September, and we hope to see you at our September 7th fair at the Yard. Hope you'll mark your calendar, and I just want to say a great big thank you for watching Turn to the Stars. We really appreciate your support, and so take good care. I'll see you next week.